Welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here and you're into 3D printing, photography, drones and tech, start now by subscribing and hitting the bell so you won't miss anything. We're talking about an amazing product today. I don't know if you already had a look at it. This is not a toy. And I found it amazing. I wasn't really expecting for that. Geek Buying reached out and said, do you want to try it? And I said, yeah. I wasn't expecting much, but I was really, really, really surprised. Let's roll the intro first and let's talk about it. This is the SculpFun iCube Pro 5 Watts. And it's like the middle brother of the iCube 3 Watts and the younger brother than the iCube Pro Max, which is 10 watts. I think this is like the best version of the three because it combines precision and speed. And I'll dive into deep on what we're talking about. This is an engraving machine. This is a portable, like desktop solution for engraving and personalizing all the stuff that you want. I mean, I've personally tried on like 5 or 6 different materials that we will see in a minute, and it worked amazingly. Works together with Lightroom. It has connectivity possibilities, Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. I personally didn't manage to connect it Wi-Fi. I mean, it sat down on my desk and it looked perfectly, so I didn't have any need to have it wireless or Bluetooth, but it has that connectivity. And what I won't do in this review is like get into deep on specs, on numbers and stuff like that. I just want to give you an overview of the possibilities of this machine in the hands of somebody that never tried an engraver before and maybe was scared of using it. I don't know, smokes and stuff like that. This little guy here comes with 2 spares EPA filters that worked amazingly in my studio when I was burning wood and cardbox. No smell was felt at all. The only little smell I felt was when I was engraving leather. I mean, that's a really, really strong smell. I'm not talking about fumes, I'm talking about smell. So when you were engraving leather, some little smell came out. The iCube has engraving size of 130 by 130 millimeters and can reach up to 10,000 millimeters per second speed. So we're talking about a very, very fast machine. Of course, it depends on the surface you want to engrave on, but I've done some tests with the machine at very, very high speed, and you will see them in a moment. Let's address the elephant in the room. Who's this machine thought for? Why was this machine produced? Who is the audience? Who are the audience? I mean, the audience are people who are beginning to engrave stuff, who don't have a lot of space. So this can stand on your desk next to your computer. Instead of a printer, you have one of these. It doesn't occupy much stuff. You can even put a regular paper printer on top of it, and it still delivers great results. It's made for people who want to personalize gadgets, engrave, leather, put their name on letters and stuff like that. A friend of mine who's a shoemaker lately knew that I got this machine, and we're working together on a project because he builds his own shoes, and I'm printing his logo all over the side. And as you can see, it came out incredibly perfect, and it looked like it was made by a famous brand. So this machine is addressed to small makers who don't have a lot of space, but still don't want to give up on quality and personalizing their items. Yes, it's suitable for beginners because it's like really, really straightforward. Once you learn how to use Lightburn, that's a software you use to send all the codes to the machine, it's like it's really enjoyable. I mean, I've learned really, really quickly a couple of years ago. So playing with this toy made me really happy. Most of all, after I saw what it's capable of. Size for small makers doesn't matter. I mean, I'm a small maker. I also have a bigger machine there in the garage collecting dust because they occupy a lot of space and they smell. They need air filtration and all stuff like that. This in one solution gives you portability, gives you clean air, or at least filtered air, and it can stay next to your computer without occupying space at all. So it's like really, really lightweight and doesn't occupy much, and it doesn't give up on any quality issue. I mean, I haven't had one fail, except one because I was stupid and I probably fired up too much power on a piece of plywood. But for the rest, all the engraves that I've done came out amazingly. So very great machine. Another huge pro is connectivity. As I said before, it can connect to the wireless, to the Wi-Fi, your home Wi-Fi, or to the Bluetooth. I didn't have that need because it will stay very close to my computer, hooked up with the cable, always ready. I want it that way because, as I said, all my other engravers are in the garage collecting dust. And the difference between this and the other one is that this I can engrave home without my wife pissing me off or the kids coming and saying, what's the smell? I mean, and I need to keep all the windows open. With this solution, it's perfect and it will stay really next to my computer. As I said, this is made for small businesses, like small makers who don't have the necessity to like print large volumes and don't have the space to host, you know, air filter, you know, tubes that go out for all the wasted area that it's around, like all in one solution. And this is great. It does all of that. It delivers high quality product. It's fast, it's reliable, it's small, and it doesn't smell. That means you can keep it in your office. All the other engravers that I have are in the garage collecting dust, because if you have them far from your eyes, sometimes you tend to forget it. But this I will have in front of my eyes because it's going to sit next to my computer, and every time I need something, it will be there, ready. And that's one of the like biggest pros of this product. Another pro of this machine is connectivity. Not all the machines that I have can go Bluetooth or wireless. This can. It's a tedious procedure to get connected to the Wi-Fi, but it does, and it works. It works really, really, really good. Again, I didn't have that problem of connectivity because I just took it on my desk, and it works perfectly. Let's get on the cons. What didn't I like about this engraver? This engraver does not have predisposition for air assist. Pretty sure all of you know what air assist is. It's like basically vacuumed air pressed like really, really in high pressure on the point of the laser so that you prevent fires, and at the same time the detail of the engraving or the cut is done perfectly. Let's start talking about some of the prints I've done. One of the first one I did was on the plywood they gave me two of these. One is missing because my kids probably took it, and I'm gonna zoom in to let you understand the quality that this like engrave has. You can't feel anything. This was done at like 80% speed and just 20% power, and you still can see it, and it looks really, really beautiful. It's a mandala design and it's engraved, but at the same time you can't feel anything under the finger. So that means it's delivering a really, really high quality engrave in a very, very fast way. And that's a plus of having a 5 watts with like a little bit more power than the 3 watts. It can up its speed to 10,000 millimeters per second and still giving you like great, great results. So this was like the test I did on wood. I didn't try to cut it because I don't think this machine is made to cut wood. I'm sure it will cut like 2 or 3 millimeters. Probably, I think I saw a review, they were cutting 5 millimeters plywood, but I would not suggest to do that because, I mean, this is not what this machine was made for. I printed out a couple of pieces of cardbox and the results are stunning. This was printed directly from the app. This was launched by the app that connected Bluetooth, and I just put the cardbox underneath, focused the lens, and printed it out, and it came out really, really good. This is a logo of my friend. This was one of the first tests I did on the cardbox. This guy does shoes. He builds and fixes shoes here in the south of Italy. He's a pro. I mean, his shoes are amazing. And thinking about working together, as I mentioned, I was curious of seeing how did this engraver perform on plastic, because plastic is something that I use a lot, 3D prints and stuff like that. And I wanted to see how it held on. This is a ski pass from the snow resort we were this year, and I just engraved my name on it. And as you can see, first try out, I chose the character and just printed through Lightroom. It came out really good. And the nice thing is, like, the power was spot on because it didn't burn the plastic, it didn't melt all the plastic around. And this can be sold like something, you know, you personalized your stuff, and it's like really well made. Two were the materials I was really curious about, because these were the challenging materials on all my other engravers. And the first was stainless steel, and the second one was leather. I already had a test with an old one I had on stainless steel. Results were not that good. I tried this at full power, half the speed of, just 50% of the speed of the machine, and this is the result I came out with. I'm gonna give you a close-up so you can enjoy it, because light reflects a lot on the stainless steel. I just found an Amazon logo and engraved it on it, and it looks really, really good. Don't mind my like scraper here, it's all like rusty and stuff. Just consider the engraving part. So I must say I'm like really impressed with this machine, even though it's only 5 watts and this is only one pass of laser. I could have done probably a couple more at the same speed, at the same power, to have more detail. But as soon as I saw it coming out, I stopped the machine and I wanted to see it, because I said, come on, 5 watts can do that? And yeah, they can. Last thing I engraved is leather. And I was curious about this. It's smelly, guys. If you like engrave on leather, get ready to taste some like really nasty smells. I mean, this is like really, really good leather from a bag that my friend is like doing, and it was just like he gave it to me to do some tests and see how it came out. I printed out Hermes logo here, and it really looks original. I mean, if he puts this on his bag, he could sell Hermes bags, even though they're not Hermes. I mean, really, really well done. This is his logo again. And this is a Starbucks logo that I've printed on to do something bigger, you know. And still, it looks good. It looks printed on. It doesn't look engraved. And that's the result we were searching for. I mean, at least I was searching for, in order to customize my stuff. I have some leather wallets. I have a leather iPod bag. And I'm gonna try and engrave my 3D Printing Geek logo on it. By the way, something that I was nearly forgetting is this here. I'm gonna show you this right now. I engraved my table, as you can see here. I just put the machine here, got the measures, and engraved my 3D Print Geek logo on top of my work table. And it worked amazingly. This was one of the first engraves that I've done. And I was impressed. I said, I'm gonna do a video just about this. But then I started testing and it came out. Results were surprising me, like day by day, as I was testing it. This is a speed power comparison. I'm an idiot because I set the power and the speed too slow and too high. And these are the results when you wanna do stuff hiring up. That's why I don't wanna focus on setting today, but just give you an overview of what this engraver is capable of. That's why I'm gonna skip all the stuff, all the inside, all the technical stuff, which are covered a lot on YouTube already. And I didn't wanna bore you. I just wanna let you understand what this machine is capable of. And for the price that it is at this moment, it's a really, really good bargain. I mean, we're talking about a really, really cheap, I wouldn't even call it entry-level engraver, because we are reaching a certain level of professionality here with the filters, with the connectivities that other very expensive engravers don't have. So entry-level, I don't know if it's an entry-level, but for sure the price is very low. All the links to buy it are again down in the description. And you can do a lot. I mean, I'm closing this review, but I'll continue testing and I will keep you updated on new materials and stuff that I do with this machine, because I was surprised. Good thing again is that it's portable and it's gonna stand very close to my desk, so I have it inside and I can use it wherever I want. That's one of the things I've loved about this engraver. That was pretty much all for today, guys. I really hope you enjoyed the video. I tried not to keep it too boring, because usually technical reviews are really, really boring. I find them really boring, or at least I search for the information I need and then I skip them. I wanted to show you what this machine is capable of in 2024, and who is it for? I mean, I'm gonna use it a lot. I'm a small maker and I love personalizing my stuff. So do you like this? So probably this is a machine for you. Thanks again, guys, for watching my video. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're not yet subscribed. And I'll see you guys on the next video.